फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर बीरेन फ्रॉम यूनिक शिक्षा। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन आईएएस मेंस जीएस लर्निंग सीरीज। दिस सीरीज हेल्प्स इंप्रूविंग द आंसर राइटिंग स्किल्स ऑफ सिविल सर्विसेज एस्पायरेंट्स। इफ यू आर आल्सो लुकिंग टू स्कोर 570 मार्क्स इन जनरल स्टडीज, देन वॉच इट रेगुलरली। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ए प्रोबेबल क्वेश्चन फॉर इंडियन पॉलिटी एंड गवर्नेंस फॉर IAS mains GS paper 2. The question is, India, the world's largest democracy, turned into an electoral autocracy. Elaborate the statement in context of the Democracy Report 2021. This statement itself appeared in the VDEM Institute report of Gothenburg University, Sweden. So let's see how we can tackle this question. Friends, first of all, we have to mark important keywords so that we can focus our answer on those keywords. The first is, we need to understand what is electoral autocracy. Second word is elaborate. So friends, you should always check for the question tag for which the answer is to be written. So in present question, you need to elaborate this statement in context of the Democracy Report 2021. You need to write this question in 150 words, and this question carries 10 marks. So just see how to discuss it. Friends, before discussing the present question, we need to understand the democracy index. This democracy index is called the Liberal Democracy Index, which is based upon 71 indicators. And these 71 indicators have further been classified into two different indexes. One is called the Liberal Component Index, and the second is called the Electoral Democracy Index, EDI. Basically, LCI captures the limits placed on governments in terms of the protection of individual liberties and the checks and balances between the institutions. In short, this index measures that how far the individual liberties, that is freedom of expression and freedom from illegal arrest and detention, is accorded to individual citizens. The second point is that how far different institutions of democracy functions. For example, how judiciary functions with other organs, executive and legislature. So if these checks and balances are adhered to and are respected, then it is said that LCI has a better results for those countries. When we talk about the EDI index, it is nothing but it looks for institutional features that guarantee free and fair elections, such as freedom of association and freedom of expression. Friends, this EDI measures nothing but it looks that how far the elections are free and fair in order to make democracy meaningful. Friends, you can structure your answer first by introducing what is electoral autocracy in 30-40 words. In body part, you can discuss how democracy in India has turned into electoral autocracy. The second aspect, you should discuss what are the evidence cited in the report in support of the argument. In conclusion part, you can conclude your elaboration as per the report, and secondly, you should also suggest some remedies to improve upon the situation as a way forward. Friends, in introduction part, you can write your answer by explaining what is electoral autocracy. You can start your answer with defining autocracy as a system of government by one person with absolute power. Then you should introduce electoral autocracy when the power of a democratically elected government in practice gets concentrated in a single person, and this single person utilizes this power as per his personal will. Next, it is to mention here that Democracy Report 2021 has not defined the term electoral autocracy, but it has stated its some features which we will discuss in our body part. In body part, you should write about how India has turned into a electoral autocracy. So the report mentions that India got a ranking 0.57 in 2013 on the scale of 0 to 1, which declined to 0.34 by the end of 2020. So this decline in the score has turned India from a democracy to a electoral autocracy, because there are certain features the report has cited and given. It is exercise of censorship by the government to contain freedom of expression of the press, civil society, etc. The second feature is decline in autonomy of the election management body, that is Election Commission of India. Next is decline in freedom and fairness of election. Besides, it also talks about that there is a decline in respect for counter argument within the government. Next is that government dissemination of domestic false information. So on these bases, different indicators have shown that India has turned into an electoral autocracy as per the Democracy Report 2021. Friends, in next point, you have to write down what are the evidences cited in the report in support of its argument. So the report mentions that degree of censorship in India on the press and the civil society is at par with Pakistan, which is worse than the Nepal and Bangladesh. In second point, the report states that defamation law has been frequently used to silence journalists. Another point was that Unlawful Activities Prevention Act UAPA has been misused by state authorities to intimidate, harass, and imprison the political opponents of the party in power. And this was the reason that this act was amended in August 2019. The report also mentions about the way the Citizenship Amendment Act movement was suppressed by the state authorities, and the university's students and activists were harassed. Another point the report mentions is suppression of civil society organizations. It mentions that the state authorities has tried to restrict entry and exit of the civil society organizations in order to control them. It also accuses that the organizations supporting the party in power are given more freedom, and the organizations otherwise are punished even with Foreign Contributions Regulation Act, where their license for receiving foreign aid has not been renewed. Friends, now you can conclude your elaboration by stating that there are several regions and instances because of which India has turned into an electoral autocracy. But you should also mention that the indicators and the methodology used by the report making agency may have certain objections. Even the government of India has refuted the report. But we have to look that whether the cited evidences, if they are true, then we should improve the condition of Indian democracy in times to come, and you should make certain suggestions for the same. You should suggest that the separation of power among the different organs of the government, the judiciary, executive, and the parliament need to be adhered, and they must be protected against the supremacy of the executive, which has been a feature of India in practice. Secondly, the system of checks and balances inbuilt within the Constitution of India should be respected. The provision of judicial review, the privileges of the Parliament as a legislative body, the powers and functions of constitutional bodies such as Election Commission of India, Comptroller General of India must be respected. Next is the concentration of power in single institution must give a way to effective devolution of power to respective agencies, and decentralization of the power must be done not in provisions but must be implemented in its true spirit. If these are the things, then indeed Indian democracy can again retain its status of a good democracy in the world. So you can conclude your answer on these positive notes. Friends, just have a re-look of answer structure. Introduce with what is electoral autocracy, and in body part, how democracy in India has turned into electoral autocracy, what are the evidences cited in the report in support of your argument, and you can conclude your answer by your observations made. You can also suggest remedies to improve as a way forward. So friends, we will be coming next week with a question on science and technology. And tomorrow you can have your blog with these words: we wish you a great career in civil services. Friends, in this corona days where offline classes are not available, Don't compromise with your study and join our IAS Live Foundation course, which provides a quality study material, live interactive classes with top teachers, and doubt resolution session. It also includes more than 100 plus tests and 750 hours of course. So please join our course. Friends, you can avail our 7-day free trial. Please sign up at uniqueshiksha.com online foundation course to access live classes, personal mentoring, test and more. Register at uniqueshiksha.com online test to evaluate your IAS answer and prepare better. You can also challenge your friends to take IAS prelim challenge. Friends, please subscribe our channel by pressing the bell icon and like, share and comment. Stay on course to realize your IAS goals. You can call on 8287360360 to avail any help. With these words, thanks for watching our video.